So we just went through a ton of very specific prompting frameworks. Now what I want to do is talk about two very effective but general frameworks that you can use for a multitude of different pieces of content. So let's get into it. These prompt frameworks are designed to be applicable to all different types of scenarios while still generating and enhancing detailed and effective outputs. So by providing this specific framework, these prompts are going to enable ChatGPT, as you know by now, to produce way more helpful and way more accurate responses. And the first of these two different types of frameworks, which by the way, they're very similar in what they do and their layout, but they're just a different way of wording things. So I suggest that you find one that works best for you and you use them regularly. So the first style, which is the RGC style, this framework is going to present a structure that can be applied to universally any type of input. And the reason it's called RGC is because we go into the role, the results, the goal, the context, and the constraints. So this is just a very concise way of creating the guidelines for ChatGPT to operate under. So if we have the role, this is ChatGPT's persona. And by the way, this is similar to what we talked about at the beginning of the chapter around what prompt engineering is, what makes a good prompt, and the steps for doing those prompts. This is taking all that information of the basic fundamental understanding and process of prompt engineering and putting it physically into a prompt that you can regularly use. So we have at the beginning ChatGPT's persona, aka you are going to act as an expert marketer. We have our result or our desired output, which is, for example, create 5 emails ending with a call to action. We have our goal, aka the purpose of the output. Let's say the goal is to drive more sales to a product. We have the context, aka the who, what, where, and why. This could be that the emails for the newsletter are for my online audience and entrepreneurs. And then we have the constraints or the limitations and guidelines for ChatGPT to act under. So this email or these emails should be friendly and less than 200 words. So now let's get into the examples. Our first one, you can copy and paste and use as your general framework. You are an expert in this field. I want you to create this with this goal in mind. This is the content, and your guidelines are the following. So let's actually move down to the third example and put this into ChatGPT. So you are an expert nutritionist. We've established ChatGPT's persona, and I want you to create a 7-day meal plan for my 5'7", 40-year-old female client that exercises 3 times a week. The goal is for her to lose 1 pound of fat per week by being in a caloric deficit and eating the right amount of carbs, sugar, and protein. She doesn't eat pork, so we're giving more specifications, aka guidelines. She doesn't eat pork. She wants to spend $200 per week on food. The meal plan should give the recipes, cooking directions, prep time, and specific meal for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. So let's put that in. And just like that, we've used this framework to create a 7-day meal plan for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. And we have the ingredients with the prep time and all of the details we need to now go out and do this. So this framework doesn't have to be just for a nutritionist. It can literally be across any field, across any discipline, and any industry. So I 100% recommend having this prompt as a cheat sheet on your computer set aside so that you can easily use it for future prompts when you're wanting a very detailed response. Now let's get into our next general prompting framework that's similar to this one, but it's reworded in a slightly different way.